Good morning. Such a pleasure to be with you again this morning. It's exceptionally on a Monday. Usually I do this live on Tuesday at the same time. So I hope you will join next week on Tuesday. And maybe it's not a bad idea to start the week with this discussion together. So don't hesitate to share your comments, your questions, so I can answer to them during the live today. For those who are joining for the first time, I am a professional coach and trainer passionate about working with you to help you identify what are your key questions, issues, and how to move forward, okay? How to get there. And today I will share with you stories, experience about how you can get unstuck, because that's really my expertise and what I like to do all day with my clients. If you joined last week, we started to discuss around this topic, and I especially explained that it's all a question about understanding our needs. If we stay on the surface for ourselves or for others, when we are talking or working with others, then we are pretty limited in terms of how we can move forward and find solutions. The idea, the great tool we all have, is listening and asking questions with curiosity. That allows to release the needs for ourselves and for others. So I already touched on this topic last week, and I'm happy to move forward today in giving you additional tips and stories how to do that. So last week, among the people who attended, I had questions about how to lead without authority, which is something that is developing more and more. Hein? So we have to influence and to sell ourselves, to sell our ideas, our services and products. So this is even more important to be able to first understand yourself and then able to understand the other and to meet their needs. So today I will propose to approach the topic of influencing yourself and others and then leading without authority from a slightly different perspective. There are two different attitudes, mindset you can have during your daily work. The first one is called judgment. The second one is called curiosity. Guess what? What is most useful and facilitating during your day? Curiosity. Otherwise, you know, if you are in judgment, you will tend to separate yourself from the problem or separate yourself from the relationship. The judgment comes when what we perceive differs from the expected reality. This gap leads to so-called negative emotion. You may feel frustrated, uncomfortable, angry, very different type of emotion that will lead you to overreact. So this goes pretty fast, and unfortunately that doesn't really help. First, you will feel bad, you will feel stuck. And secondly, the relationship is not gonna move forward. So you will not be able to find a solution. And even when you are talking to yourself, okay, something happens and you expected something different. So really important to understand the mechanism there. And to understand that judgment is also very useful for us if we reflect on it and say, oh, okay, I realize I was in judgment here. What's going on for me? So ask yourself the question about what were your expectations and what is your perception of the current situation? Because there is not only one way to look at a situation, and expectations are in fact rarely met. because this is coming from our own mind, and we are not alone on this earth. So, you know, people act in different ways, situations are very different. So it's pretty rare that actually the situation is exactly as we plan. So it's putting a lot of pressure on ourselves to do that, isn't it? Okay, so when there is judgment, there is what we name an unmet need. So it's important to ask yourself what's going on for me so that you can identify this unmet need. When you are at this stage where you have identified this unmet need, let's say that you needed recognition, appreciation, or you needed security, or you know, there are very different type of needs, could be also surprise, and you didn't get from your perception this thing, you have two possibilities. You can enter what we name a drama triangle, where you feel like a victim, and you know you are then having no solution. You are depending on the external to move forward, so this is not very comfortable. Or you can decide that you want to move forward, and although you were in judgment, you now want to move in curiosity by asking yourself questions. What could this mean also for the other person? And if you have this, or for the environment, if you have this type of question, you will find a way. You will find a solution to move away from the judgment and through the curiosity, find a new approach. So, and please don't hesitate to comment, and to add or summarize what I'm saying. This helps me because we are not all together in the same room here. Helps me to see if that's useful for you. So let me share a story. I work for different companies and I support their teams and leaders. And often people have very limited time to find solutions. So they get stuck and they get stressed because they have only a few minutes to move forward, to decide something and move forward. So what I developed almost 15 years ago now, when I started as a coach, was what we name speed coaching. So this involves exactly what I've just described. So helping people to move away from judgment and being curiosity so that they can find their own solution. So this starts with thinking about what's happening for them and frame that as a question around what they want. Already, when you are framing the question as a want, that helps you to escape from the situation of the moment. We get stuck because we are thinking about the past or we are playing a victim mindset. As soon as you are focusing on your want and you are framing as a question, how can I get to move forward, you know, thinking about really the future, then you will be creating it already. Then ideas will come. They will come as images or as words, and listen to that and just write down, okay? So you start with the question around how to get what you want, and then let your mind come naturally, intuitively, with keywords. Don't judge, be in pure curiosity. And look at these words or as this image and then say, okay, so what is the link between this word and my question? Usually when you do that, because you are thinking about these words or images for a good reason, then you are finding an idea. And then you can continue to ask questions, say, okay, how can I use this idea to move forward? So this can happen very quickly. It's a habit of the mind to turn any situation into a question and let your intuition naturally connect with solution. So I have applied that successfully in very different settings when people have very limited time and when they want to feel unstuck. And that was the start of my, career as a coach, actually. Through this success, I got, new clients, and I continue to train and explore further how I could help people to get unstuck. But this is really my story and also the link with this topic of getting unstuck. So I'm very happy to share that with you this morning. And yeah, maybe you can try today and let me know how it works. I would be very happy if you want to share your experience with this tip. You can apply this week and we can talk further next week. So this is especially useful when you are leading without authority. The listening and the asking question is really fundamental to get to know the people, understand their motivations, their values, and how you can engage them naturally to work together. So, very happy to share that with you today. I hope it will help you this week. You can, if you want to talk further about how you could apply that in your life, if you are interested in what I'm offering to teams and individuals, you can reach to me at christine@billycoaching.com or go on my website, billycoaching.com. You will see that I am offering coaching, trainings, and facilitation for teams, and I will be very happy to talk about your specific needs. In the meantime, I wish you a great day, and don't hesitate again to comment on the show. I will soon again start interviewing with leaders, so that will give you also other opportunities to see how people get unstuck and get to create products and services linking to their natural strengths. Okay, so I was very happy to start the week with you, and I hope to see you again on Tuesday next week, or otherwise, feel free to reach to me. Okay, bye-bye. Have a good day.